Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today in this video I will discuss about the agencies of socialization. So I have very well much clear to you the meaning of socialization in my video of the Erikson theory of socialization. I have given the link below this video. You can see the whole theory and you will very much understand the meaning of the socialization. So in this video, I will discuss very important topic from the TET or CTET or other state at point of view in the child development and psychology, the agency of socialization. So here these are the agencies. First is the family, second is the school, third is the society, and fourth is the state. I will discuss about them step by step and I will try to clear you very much in detail about them. So first I try about the family. Family as the agency of the socialization. Let's talk about it. Family is the agency of the socialization. First point here come is the first school. Family is the first school where we think, where we learn all the things. So it is responsible for the survival and the security of the child immediately after birth. So the socialization comes first from the first school, that is the family. Next is the development of the social quality. Social quality, family formation is also a social quality, group living. So that come from the family. So who we can inculcate the social quality, they all come from the family. So cooperation, goodwill, mutual understanding, sense of subordination for the interest of other, sense of belongingness are the cardinal social virtue that come from the family. Next is the satisfaction of the psychological needs. Psychological needs, how they satisfy our brain, such as the love, affection, recognition, security, approval, freedom, they are come from the family. So satisfaction of the psychological needs come from the family. Foundation of the character. Family lay the character foundation. So character of our parents, our grandparents, very much affect our character build-up. Development of the civic sense. So civic sense, good citizenship that come from the family. Citizenship between that is the mother's kiss and the father care, that is very much important. So it is the family which help the child in realizing and discharging his duties and responsibilities. So responsibility and duties paid by the father and mother, grandmother, father, they inculcate us the civic values. Next is the development of the mode of behavior. Behavior modification, behavior development, that also come from the family. Good behavior of our parents, our cousins, our peer group, that very much affect our behavior. Development of the language. Language fluency. We first son, ma, pa, father, mother, uncle, auntie, brother, sister, they all come from the family. So good fluency of the language, use of the vocal cords, tongue and teeth and vocal cavity, they all listen and control manner gained by our families. Conveyor of the tradition. So good tradition of the family are conveyed from the family to the child. Vocational choice. So vocational choice is very much important thing, such as if the farmer and the son, the farmer has a good land of like agriculture, they can give the vocation to the child. Such as the engineer, a doctor, of the shopkeeper, they can give the vocation to their progeny. I hope the family role in socialization is clear to you. Next agency is the school. School as the agency of the socialization. Here first is the transmission and enrichment of the color, culture. So culture, what is the tradition of the school, is transmitted to the student. So here the help in enrichment and modification of culture. and construct the human behavior. Better way in the school. Promotion of the social efficiency. Social efficiency, social adjustment, overcome the maladjustment in society by the game, sport, social services, that all come in the child and it improves the social efficiency. Next is the cultivation of higher value. Higher value are cultivated by the school, such as morality is a very high value. It should be very much necessary in the child. Difference between right and wrong, sense of sympathy, satyam shivam sundaram, that is very truth, goodness and beauty. So it is very much developed by the school. Post school adjustability. So the school has a direct responsibility of preparing the individual child for the post school adjustment. School should produce the citizen who are physical fit, intellectually enlightened, emotionally balanced and vocationally efficient. So all type of the balance is inculcated by the school. So by the education in the school doesn't meaning having the certificate of the higher secondary or the secondary classes, but it should have our balanced characters. So it is the post school adjustability that is given by the school. Imparity vocational training. So vocational training is also given, imparted here. Training for the leadership. Leadership quality also given the class CR monitor, head of the school. These also the things that inculcate the training of the leadership quality. NSS and the NCC also inculcate it. Complete development of the individual. Individual complete development is done in the school by the co-curricular and extracurricular activities. I hope the role of the school as the agency of socialization is clear to you. Next, third is the society as the agency of the socialization. Society. Society, first, the establishment of good school. So, society, good leader, good head can provide the good school. So, establishment of the good school can be done by the society. Next, the establishment of good library. So, good library, the as you know, the book are the foundation of good character and good moral value. So, socialization done by the library is very important thing. So, society can give the good library. Adult education. Education of the age individual should be provision here. It can be done by the society. So, educated adult can give more and more thing to the society. Literacy and culture education, literary and the culture education. So here we can provide very much thing inculcating literary and the culture education. So various literary and the culture activities should be organized by these institutions. In our country, there is a number of the literary and culture institutions which frequently organize a lecture, discussion and debate, poetical recitation and symposium, one-act play and music competition. So these institutions, literary and the culture institution, can provide much more socialization. Vocational education should be done. Society can provide it. Vocational institute can. Training institute can be established. Inculcating the moral, spiritual and noble value. In noble value can be done by society by establishing the religious institution. Coordinating various agencies. Various agencies coordination can be made by the good society efficient leader. Next we have the state as the agency of socialization. See the citizenship. First is the role of the state is the training the citizenship. So citizenship training can be done by the state. So good trained citizen can impart good social development to the society. Economical training. For the state must open the institution for training the science, industry and agriculture. They can provide good economy to the nation. Cultural training. Cultural training can also be done by the society, by creating the galleries, culture, communities, means of recreation, day celebration can also give up. Social training can give फिजिकल एंड मेंटल मॉरल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ पीपल, पॉलिटिकल ट्रेनिंग, पॉलिटिकल ट्रेनिंग, डेमोक्रेटिक सोसाइटी, रोल ऑफ द डेमोक्रेसी, मीनिंग ऑफ द लीडर, मीनिंग ऑफ द सोसाइटी, दे कैन बी इंक्लूडेड बाय द स्टेट. सो हियर दीज आर द एजेंसीज ऑफ द सोशलाइजेशन एंड दे दीज थिंग कैन वेरी मच अफेक्ट द सोशलाइजेशन. In the last, there is a brief discussion is the role of the teacher in process of socialization. So teacher can very much affect the socialization process by the transmission of culture. So good custom, convention, tradition, values can be transmitted by teacher. If the teacher is of the good character, it can transmit the good social value. Social ideas, social ideals can be given by the teacher. So in the playground, various cultural activity can be performed. Next is the tradition of the school. School good tradition very much of influence the socialization. Encouragement of the group work. Group work can be encouraged by teacher. So it also affect the social adjustment of the student. Encouragement to the healthy competition. Healthy competition can be done. So here sense of jealousy should not be. So it will be the positive attitude. Spirit of competition should be there. Encouragement here, healthy human relation. Healthy human relation can be here. The negative alley and jealousy should not be there. Development of the intercultural feeling. So intercultural feeling can be best to be provided by the teacher by various cultural activities. I hope, friend, I could made avail to you for the various agencies of the socialization. So it is very important and fundamental topic from the tech point of view in the child development psychology. If you like this video, subscribe my channel and share this video. If you want to see the Erikson theory of socialization, you can search the link given below. Thank you very much.